Hi, hello, namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. In this video, we are going to get the information about 9th standard social science English medium history chapter number 2, medieval India and political transition. Let's come to the what are the very important learning points from the lesson Medieval India and Political Transition. In this chapter, you learn the Rajput dynasties that ruled in North India, the contributions of Rajput kings to literature, art and architecture, the arrival of Turks, the impact of Muhammad Ghazni and Muhammad Ghori inventions, the establishment of the Delhi Sultanate, their administration and their contribution. So let's come to the what is the introduction for the lesson. So here is a question, transitional period. So what is the meaning of transitional period? The period between the second half of the 12th century and the first half of the 13th century is recognized as the transitional period in Indian history. Remember, the second half of the 12th century and first half of the 13th century is recognized as the transitional period. Transitional period indicates the preparedness of the society to enter from one era to another era. That means, if you are writing the exam, needs to be the preparation. In the same way, here also, entering from one era to another era needs to be the preparedness of the society. So that in this transitional period, the Indian society entered the medieval period from ancient period. So here in this India, it is entered to the medieval period from ancient period, from the ancient period to medieval period. That is, in generally, we are going to be identify from one era, that means ancient period, another era, that is medieval period. So that is, from ancient period to medieval period needs to be the preparedness. That is, we used to call it as transitional period. Behind this transitional period, the very important role, that is the Turks. The Turks broke the political system of small kingdoms in India. Their role, it is a significance, especially in India. They also established an empire which had a strong centralized power structure. Because of when medieval period in India, there will be an existence of small kingdoms, but that small political system completely broke by the Turks. Monotheism was expounded in the field of religion due to the influence of Islam. So, as the India, we are worshipping many gods. It is a land of gods, but as the Turks, basically they are follower of monotheism, means worshipping of one god, believe in one god. So that expounded in the field of religion, especially the influenced Islam religion in India. All these developments indicate the beginning of medieval period in India. So, before the study of the empire established by the Turks, it is necessary to understand the multi-state political system in pre-Turk period. So, that is multi-state political system, nothing but it is called as the small kingdom. The rule of small kingdoms is called as multi-state political system. The study of multi-state political system can be started with the study of Rajput dynasties before the arrival of Turk. So we are going to be get the information about that is multi-state political system with the studying Rajput dynasties that ruled. Rajputs, they ruled western and northern part of India from 9th century to 13th century. Let's come to the about Rajput dynasties. How they are ruled? What are their contributions? Yes, Rajput dynasties. Before the arrival of Rajput, as we are get the information about that, Rajput, they ruled in the western and northern part of India. By the way, before this part of western and northern part of India was ruled by Mauryas, Guptas, Kushans, Cholas, Pallavas, Vardhanas. Among that, Shatavineshwara was the most powerful ruler of the Vardhanas, the part of western and northern part of area or India was ruled. Then after, the Rajput dynasty followed the important dynasties like Gurjara Pratiharas, Chandelas of Bundelkhand, Garhawalas, Solankis, Paramars and many other Rajput dynasties. They provided their administration system in the western and northern part of India. And very importantly, by the end of 12th century, Rajput kings like Prithviraj Chauhan, Jayachandra of Garhwal and Paramaradhi Deva Chandela, these are the rulers become very powerful kings in the northern part of India. Let's come to the one by one, the very important dynasties of Rajput. We are going to get the more information. Among that, the first one, Gurjara Pratiharas. About the Pratiharas have claimed in many their inscription. That shows that Lakshmana of Ramayana period, a Kshatriya of Surya Vamsha as the founding person of their family. But as per the available evidences, it's considered the founder of Gurjara Pratiharas is Naghabatta. The founder of the Gurjara Pratiharas, the founder is Naghabatta. And their capital, Kanauz. Kanauz is their capital. The very powerful kings of this dynasty are Naghabatta, Miharabhuj and Mahendrapala are the very important powerful rulers of Gurjara Pratiharas. And the last king of this dynasty, Mahipala. Let's come to the, we are going to get more information about Gurjara Pratiharas. The Pratiharas ruled Sindh region by keeping Kanauz as their capital city. They fought back the frequent attack by the Arab. So by the way, the part of Sindh region, it is continuous attack, frequent attack by the Arabs. Somehow, they fought back the frequent attack of the Arabs. Among that, Miharabhuja and Mahendrapala, powerful rulers of this dynasty, they defeated Palas of Bengal and extended their Pratihara kingdom up to Bengal. And there is a Arab traveler named called as Sulaiman who was visited to the court of Miharabhuja and appreciated the kingdom as it had peace. In his words, he expressed about the administration system of Miharabhuja by Sulaiman. Pratiharas rule declined during the rule of Mahipala. So as he was considered as the last ruler and who was succeeded by Mahendrapala. So somehow they provided wonderful administration system as a Rajput dynasties. So let's come to the next one dynasty that is called as Garhwalas. The founder of this dynasty, Chandradeva. Chandradeva is the founder of Garhwalas, and their capital was Varanasi. The very important famous rulers of this dynasty are Govindachandra and the last ruler of this dynasty, Jayachandra. So let's come to the how Govindachandra has provided his administration system in the Garhwalas. He extended his rule till the Malwa and Magadha, defeating Palas. He also defeated the kings of Kalinga and Odisha. The rulers of Kashmir, Gujarat and Chola had cordial relationship with Govindachandra. Somehow he is also provided wonderful relationship as under the Garhwalas, one of the powerful ruler. So among that, Govindachandra is the most powerful ruler and his contributions. So this is about Garhwalas. Let's come to the about Paramaras. The founder of Paramaras, Upendra Krishna Raja, and the capital of Paramaras, Dharanagara. Dharanagara is the capital of Paramaras. And the most famous king of this dynasty, Bhoja. Bhoja Raja is the most famous king. And the last king of this dynasty, Arjun Varman. Arjun Varman is the last ruler of Paramaras. About that, Bhoja Raja. Bhoja is the most popular king of Paramara dynasty, whereas he extended the Paramara state by defeating the Kalyani Chalukyas, Kalinga Gangas and Nardran Konkans. Though Bhoja experienced high and downs in political sphere, remained undefeated in the area of literature. Himself, he is a great poet, and he has given much importance in the field of literature. As the after the ruler of Bhoja Raja, they were very weak and inefficient to look over the administration system. Thus, Paramara cities come to an end after the Bhoja Raja. And the next dynasty of Rajput, that is Solankis. The founder of this dynasty, Mula Raja. Mula Raja was the founder of Solankis. The capital of this dynasty, Anil Wada. And the famous kings of this dynasty, Bhima first, Mula Raja second, Veeradhawala, are the very famous rulers of this Solankis dynasty. And the last ruler of this dynasty, Karnadeva. As some of the most famous kings, we are get to know about that. Bhima first is the most famous king of this dynasty, but he could not protect the Somanatha temple from the Ghazni's invasion. So what Muhammad Ghazni, he invaded 17 times on India, one among that is to the Somanatha temple, such a greatest temple in India during Solankis dynasty. But Bhima first, he was unable to protect the invasion of the Ghazni, that is to the Somanatha temple. But after Mula Raja second and Veeradhawala were the capable kings of Solankis, but Mula Raja second, he defeated Muhammad Ghazni near Mount Abu. So he, you know, the revenge has taken by Mula Raja second against his grandfather, like Bhima first was defeated in the hands of the Muhammad Ghazni. That revenge has been fulfilled by Mula Raja second defeating Muhammad Ghazni at Mount Abu. Even as he, Mula Raja second, somehow he has been provided wonderful administration system. When Mula Raja second was ruling, one of the famous Jain scholar named called as Hemachandra, he was in the court of Mula Raja second and compiled a Prakrit dictionary named called as Deshimala. Deshimala, one of the Prakrit dictionary was composed by Jain scholar name called as Hemachandra. He was in the court of Mula Raja II. So, but after that, Ulugh Khan and Nusrat Khan, these are the military generals of Alauddin Khilji. So, Alauddin Khilji, Delhi Sultan's Khilji dynasty, the popular ruler name called as Alauddin Khilji. His military generals name called as Ulugh Khan and Nusrat Khan, these are the military generals, they defeated the last ruler of the Solankis name called as Karnadeva and made the kingdom of Solankis as a part of Delhi Sultanate. Anyhow, Solankis also provided a wonderful administration system. So, let's come to the next dynasty, that is Chandelas. The founder of this dynasty, Nanuka. Nanuka was the founder of Chandelas. Whereas the capitals of Chandelas are Khajuraho and Mahobha are the capitals of Chandelas. And the very famous king of this dynasty, Danga. Danga is the most famous king and last king of this dynasty, Veeravarman. Veeravarman is the last ruler of Chandelas. Anyhow, Danga has provided wonderful administration system. He is considered as the most famous king among the Chandelas. He is from the Bundelkhand, Chandelas of Bundelkhand. In the beginning, Chandelas were the feudatory kings under the Pratiharas. Feudatory kings, that means they are under the control of the feudatory kings of Pratiharas. After the decline of Paramaras, Danga, the famous ruler of Chandelas, declared himself as an independent ruler. He took hold the eastern part of Paramaras kingdom and extended his kingdom, defeating the Palas and Adras. Pala and Adras. Danga, who had the title name called as Maharajadi Raja, King of Kings, extended military assistance to Hindu Shahi King Jayapala to fight back attacking Turks. So here, Danga earned the title name called as Maharajadi Raja or King of Kings because he helped the Hindu Shahi King name called as Jayapala. That is the reason he earned the title Maharajadi Raja. Finally, due to infighting and lack of unity among the Rajput, Khilji Sultans conquered Chandelas kingdom. And the next dynasty of Rajputs, that is Chauhans. The founder of this dynasty, Vigraharaja II, is the founder. The capital of this dynasty, Ajmer. And the famous kings of this dynasty are Ajaya Raja, Vigraharaja IV, Prithviraj III are the most famous kings of this dynasty. The last king of this dynasty was Prithviraj III. As the Chauhan's dynasty is the most prominent among the Rajputs. So till now what we have discussed the different dynasties. Among all the dynasties, the Chauhan's dynasty is the most prominent among the Rajputs. The root of this dynasty, it is visible during the 7th century. That means the beginning of this administration system, that is from the 7th century. The dynasty started its rule in the Ajmer region of Rajasthan. They started their administration system, that is from Ajmer region from the Rajasthan. The rulers of this dynasty are Ajaya Raja, Vigraharaja IV and Prithviraj III. Made Chauhans the prominent rulers and the Western India during the 12th century. The most famous king among the Chauhans is Prithviraj Chauhan. Known for his bravery, defeated the Chandelas of Bundelkhand, gaining Mahebha and Kalinzar. Even the great Mohammed Ghori was attacked on Prithviraj Chauhan. So those battles are called as the Terrain Wars. Let's come to the how this battle it is fought between Prithviraj Chauhan and Mohammad Ghori. Prithviraj Chauhan defeated Mohammad Ghori at Terrain. It is called as the First Battle of Terrain, that is fought in the year 1191 CE. The reason behind, Ghori wanted to extend his Ghor kingdom towards the Sindh region. As a result of that, Mohammad Ghori was severely wounded in the First Battle of Terrain. So, led to another attack towards the Delhi in the following year. Then, so to take the revenge by the Mohammad Ghori against Prithviraj Chauhan, he made some of the very important preparations against the Prithviraj Chauhan. And in the next year, 1192, he made an attack on Prithviraj Chauhan. He defeated Prithviraj Chauhan at Terrain in the Second Battle of Terrain War. So, Prithviraj Chauhan is embodiment of Rajput value and bravery for well known his braveness and impersonation of the Rajput dynasties. So, this is about the Rajput dynasties. So, let's come to the what are the very important contributions has been provided by Rajputs. Among that, the literature contributions of the Rajputs. The Rajputs who ruled during the last part of ancient and early part of medieval period. They provided their administration system, last part of ancient, early part of medieval period. They encouraged the art, culture and religion liberally. Rajput kings themselves, they were scholars. So among that, Bhoja, Munja have written various literary works. Even the king of Munja had poets like Padmagupta and Halayuddha in his court. King Bhoja had extended his royal patronage to the Jain scholars, name called as Shantisena, Prabhachandra Suri and Ganapala during the rule of Bhojaraja. So, like this, importance has given in the field of literature. So, let's come to the what are the very important literary contribution has been provided by Rajputs. Among that, these are classified into as a different parts. Number one, that is poetic works. So, which are the poetic works? So, students, it is for 3 marks, very important, concentrate it. Jayadeva's Gita Govinda, Bharavi's Kiratarjuneya, Bhartruhari's Ravana Vadha, Mahendrapala's Kavya Mimamse. So, these are the very important poetic works. And the next, dramas like Rajashekara's Bala Ramayana and Karpura Manjari, Bhavabhuti's Mahavira Charita and Uttara Ramacharita. So, these are the very important dramas. That is Rajashekara's Bala Ramayana and Karpura Manjari, Bhavabhuti's Mahavira Charita and Uttara Ramacharita. And next, historical works like Kalhana's Rajatarangini, Jayanika's Prithviraja Vijaya, Hemachandra's Kumarapala Charita. So, these are very important historical works and some of the biographies of the Rajput rulers. Among that, Prithviraja Rasu by Chand Bardhai, Bhoja Prabandha by Ballada. So, these are some of the very important biographies of Rajput rulers. So, even Rajputs, they have developed Gujarati, Rajasthani, Hindi languages during their administration system. And educational institutions like Nalanda, Kashi, Vikramashila, Ujjaini received a support from the Rajputs, especially the development of educational field. So, these are the very important literary contribution has been provided by Rajputs. So, let's come to the about art and architecture, the contribution what they have provided. The Rajput kings constructed spacious forts in Chittor, Mandu, Ranthambore, Jodhpur and Gwalior. So this is about Chittor and this is about Mandu, Ranthambore, Jodhpur, then Gwalior. So even they have been built beautiful palaces like Jaipur, Gwalior and then Udaipur are the very important palaces they have been built by Rajputs. And then they constructed some of the very important temples like Dilwara temple, Vimala temple and Lunavasai temples were built on Mount Abu. All these are beautiful and known for the artistic architecture. The Chandelas built Khanderaya's temple in Khajuraho. So this is Khanderaya's temple in Khajuraho built by Chandelas. That is Shiva and Vishnu temples were more in number among the temples built during their reign. Even Rajputs, they also encouraged painting. So paintings like it is classified into two parts, Rajasthani painting style and Pahari style of painting. So what you are seeing, this is the Rajasthani painting style. These are, we can see in Mewar, Bikaner, Jodhpur, Jaisalmer and Buni. And Rajasthani painting style we can see in Kasauli, Jammu and Garhwal. So these are Pahari style of paintings we can see in these places. So like this, the Rajputs have a special place in the history of India because such a wonderful contribution, either it is administration or it is in the field of literature or it is in the field of art and architecture, either it is a painting, such a they have took the very significant place in the history. So this is about Rajputs. I hope you have understood the concept till now what we are discussed, and I will come back with the next topic, the continued part of history second lesson. Until, keep watching my channel. Thank you. See you in the next session. Bye bye.